We've got these broad themes of, make in India and et cetera. But broadly, I want to hear first from them an overall sense of their journey on what's happening with this business environment, what's happened in the past, and what their experience is given the tone of the day.
Focus on, how to empower SMEs to first tackle their issues in a ground level. Second thing, we know a lot of issues coming up, those entrepreneurs, when they go for a beyond boundary, but particularly to finding new businesses. Friends, let me clarify one thing. There are so many organizations in India, but particularly on the SME growth point of view, we have started last 23 years, the SME Chamber of India, and we are reviewing the entrepreneurs or companies' growth, and we are providing the handholding for a go above, beyond boundary. But small entrepreneurs or medium entrepreneurs, they should focus on, they're in a specific market. Another very interesting thing, government is giving more thrust on, export promotion, but government is not focusing particularly SMEs to identify the market. Very important thing, the Maharashtra government, we are pursuing for last 5 years to set up one sale for SME export promotion center. Still, they are not taken care and they are not doing that. Another very interesting thing, under this Make in India initiative, we are very happy that Prime Minister has, initiated this concept. He has covered all the sectors in that. But he has not seen that if any investment coming in a particular sector, is that impacting to local small and medium companies or my entrepreneurs facing problem with the competitors? How? Viranji, let me clarify very, very bluntly. Foreign companies coming with the abundant, adequate finance or capital, they have advanced technology, they have a ready-made market, they have quality manpower, they have support from their local government, and most important, our government is providing red carpet treatment. How many times your file has cleared by a secretary, joint secretary instantly? Never. But if there is a foreign investor is coming, I know chief minister, prime minister, minister, or everybody is available to meet them, red carpet treatment. So government should focus. We know Make in India is an advantage for Indian SMEs because we are going to supply, but they should focus on the new. Particularly, our industry should not kill. Yesterday, I met more than at least 120 people, and particularly in that, I found 40-45 companies are sick. Now we have started identifying and collecting database from India. Those companies are having surplus industrial premises. Those industries having the ready-made industrial premises. And those SMEs become sick and they want to tie up with any particular. So we are getting regularly inquiries from Make in India initiative that connecting with the SME sector. So this is one part of our local. Now thinking, working local and thinking global. See, there are so many countries, they are ready to welcome you. Those are capable. Those are having the advanced technological production. Those are having the particular ideas. They can go beyond. Yeah, last month I was in Poland. The Poland government is providing handholding to SMEs. They are inviting SMEs. Even Slovenia, small country in Europe, they are ready to welcome Indian SMEs. And they are providing very good rate for an industrial plot. Even I was in Texas, so there is also the mayor, mayor office told me that they are interested to invite SMEs. So friends, think you can work locally, but think globally. If the Prime Minister of India is initiating this Make in India, how look at that, Trump is also working a different way. So why not? First, we have to think future of our SMEs. That's why we are working, and that's why we are here today to discuss. Thank you.
I'll just move away from that and say, what are the challenges for a small and medium enterprise competing, and especially where, you know, the import barriers don't apply? And I'll direct this to Viren first. Where does he see the challenge in quality stroke technology of an Indian business SME competing on the global stage? So I'm actually taking him on by saying, think globally, yes, but how do I actually compete on those two issues, technology and quality?
Not a big issue. I'm going to go on a totally different approach. Technology is overrated in terms of it's not the only thing that you can compete on. I've seen good Indian companies, competitors of ours, who don't have high technology, and yet they are competing globally. They don't have advanced machines. They've just got they've got simple machines. They've got simple techniques. I went into that shop and said, hey, you can't manufacture like this. I'd do it differently. But they're doing it the way they are, and they're succeeding. They're profitable. They're competing with other manufacturers. They're competing with us. They're competing with global companies. And they're doing very, very well. And they're extremely profitable. So I have the belief that, yes, if we can get onto technology, I love automation. I love low cost automation. I believe it's the future. I don't believe that's going to reduce our employment. I just believe it means our skill sets will change. We'll have different people who will be more skilled in the way they use the automation. But it's something that I believe is important for all of us. But I go back just to address the question. I would not be overawed by the fact, oh my God, I'm going to export, or I need to supply to an MNC in India, and I need to have very high technology. If you have access to it, if it's possible, if it's a differentiator, God bless, that's the right way to go. But I'm just trying to say it's not the only factor. The one I would believe is important, if you ask me again, I'm going to take it down to very basic, simple things that I've seen. I believe the one thing which we all often miss out, I've missed out, so I'm not even trying to say, I'm not giving you advice without, I'm talking about the facts that we've made mistakes as an established company when I joined, and I've been with Sigma just 5 years. When I joined, we didn't have good relations with our customers, we did not have very good relations, we had outstanding relations, really wonderful relations over 30 years, nurtured, and I've worked with other MNCs and I've seen those relationships, and I come to Sigma and I see outstanding relationships. Despite that, there were occasions, many occasions, when we would default in submitting our quotations on time, responding to the customer on time. I would get complaints. When you've got a big business, you're going to see complaints. And that's the point, the lesson that I learned, that can we bring that back on track? Customers expect us to deliver on time, quote on time, communicate on time. At least in India, at least in the operations I run, and I've seen it with others also, delivery nahi karna hai to batayenge hi nahi. We will not tell the customer. We will keep quiet until the day has come, gone, storm is hit, then we go and tell. And the customers come up and say, why in heavens did you not just tell me that it's going to be delayed? Aap bata do na, tell us it's going to be delayed. We'll work out something alternative. We could have done something in the market. Culturally, we don't do it. So it's a mix of these things which I believe can make the difference. And I believe, again, I'm going to talk from a global point of view, I believe as India, as people, from our culture, we are far better than many other companies and countries in Asia from the way they operate. I think there's a basic niceness in Indians which we should take full advantage of. I must make this comment because I deal day in and day out with global customers worldwide. Because of the way we behave often, we are very well respected and liked worldwide. There's a likability about Indians, which is not so with other manufacturers, other companies in Asia. I don't even have to name them. You know, Donald Trump has been saying enough about China, but these practices are not liked at the end of the day. And what we do is very much liked if we do it consistently. So I just say we got a lot of goodness in us. Can we bring that to the fore? Can we bring that out into making sure that our relationship with customers is exceptionally strong?
So before I, go to Chandrakant again, but I just wanted Viren to, reflect on one question and then maybe a response. Based on what he said about customer relations and how we deliver, and he also mentioned he's a practitioner of lean and green, I want him to think about how important is process. And many of us think of it as bureaucracy, but no. How important is process there? And where does he believe that the Indian experience lets us down? Because we say process is not important, the outcome is important. So before he responds, and I had an anecdote to share from a Japanese client of ours, and this is backing what he's saying about overcommitting or not delivering. And he had he said very nice things about India and Indians, and he has been in India for a lot of years. And his simple point was, it's a long story he had, but a simple point was, a Japanese guy who can deliver 100 will promise 80. Indian guy who can deliver 100 or will struggle to deliver 100, will say, kaam ho jayega sab 120. Okay? What happens, fast forward, this is a long story, so he had about 10 minutes to give the story, I don't have it. But finally, and he walked through the process, what happened in the plant, what happened here, what happened this, and every problem, dekh lenge. But anyway, he said, when D-Day came, the Indian guy delivered 80. The Japanese guy delivered 100. The problem was, for the customer, Indian guy has fallen by 50% because you committed to 120. You've fallen 40. You've not fallen 20%. You've fallen 50%. And in his mind, you become unreliable. And the Japanese guy is a delivery over 25% of target because he committed only 80 and delivered what he could deliver. So I think, believe me, I am in the consulting business, and I know when a client calls up like Viren Joshi and says, when will I get this advisor note, and I tell him tomorrow, and I don't know how it will happen tomorrow. So we are afraid to tell somebody, customers included, schedules included, contracts included, that we can't do this at the right price. So that's a softer aspect, but we'll move on. So Viren, process.
Yesterday evening, I was just reflecting. I had a few minutes. I said, let me just put down my thoughts of what I want to talk about today and just the important thoughts for the day. So I'd covered about, I'll be frank, there were 10 points, I'd covered 9. And I turned around to my wife, who's in the small and medium scale industry and on the hospitality side. And I told her, sweetheart, just look at this list and see if there's anything missing on it. And she zeroed, you've not covered process. So that answers it in one way, and I truly believe in it. It's not that I
Your wife called me.
My wife did catch me. Like, all really, she did catch out on that. And I truly believe it's one of the most important. I just didn't call it out at that moment, so I'm very glad she didn't. I'm very glad I was asked that question. I truly believe the one thing that we across India, and I'm talking India at this moment in a positive sense, but we miss out is the importance of what I call standard operating procedures, process. Hum process oriented nahi hai. We just do not value process. And I'm being very open, even in my own company, which is very, very well run. It's global standards and beyond. When I joined, many of our operating processes needed improvement. So that's where we all come from. So again, that point is extremely important. If all of you are to do one, there's several one things you need to do. But one thing I would say, especially in the manufacturing, but it's across anything. Even if you're in the service industry, process will beat everything else. If you can make that happen, your life is made. So process is extremely important and the most underrated. Koi nahi karta hai. Nobody does it with the strength and vigor and detailing that is really required. We just don't do it. I can challenge all of us, including myself. So don't think I'm standing here giving you advice and I myself am the first to say in my own company, I believe there's a lot more I would love to do and we will do. We're on it, but karna hai.